Jen?
The welcome comes first.
The welcome comes first, so that's actually a little bit more of an up-tempo greeting type song that welcomes everybody. Back in the old days, the blind Irish harper, national bard of Ireland, Turlock O'Carolan, would wander the countryside with his horse and his little satchel of money in his heart, playing at all of the big houses. And he had been blinded by smallpox at the age of 18. And that's how he made his living, much like Janet does today, wandering to all the coffee shops along I-5, composing tunes and playing these beautiful airs for the patrons that he would meet along the way. So it's not quite the 1700s like the days of O'Carolan, but these tunes, at least about 250 of them, have been thankfully preserved because there were certain archivists that went to harp conventions, a particular Nathaniel Gap, I believe was one of his names. He was a Scottish Bunting, that's what I'm trying to think of, Ed von Bunting. But anyway, Janet, you're the harper, you should be telling these stories.
Oh, yes.
Speaking into the mic.
Well, Turlock O'Carolan did name a lot of his tunes after people that he stayed with, because if it hadn't been for the wealthy Irish and Anglo-Irish patrons, he would not have been able to make a livelihood. So he was on the roads with his horse and his harp and a small boy to guide him because he was blind. And he went from wealthy patron to wealthy patron. And if he liked the amount of booze they gave him, especially the booze and also the clothing and food, but those are incidentals, if they gave him some good grog, he would write a tune and name it after him. He was a great composer. Sadly, we don't know how he played them because they were written down decades later and just the melodies survived, and Bunting put church organ arrangements on them. But we sort of ignore those. We just play the melodies our way.
Scared me.
music of O'Carolan. Actually, I have a CD that we made back in 1998. Got violin, harp, dulcimer, about 12 different instruments on it.